Hey guys, it's Oliver, and today I'm going to be making a video. It's a topic I haven't really talked about before. It's going to be a money video, and I'm actually going to tell you guys how you can save thousands of dollars while you're a teenager, you know, between like, I don't know, when you first get a job to 19, 20. I mean, honestly, this advice would work for some 40-year-olds, because a lot of 40-year-olds don't know shit about money and they're broke as fuck. So I'm going to teach you guys, this isn't really going to be how to make the money. This is going to be the strategy to save the money at pretty much any level of income, okay? Because a lot of people just can't save money to save their fucking life. A lot of people make six figures, can't save a dime. A lot of people make, shit, $20,000 a year, can't save a dime. Well, that's a little more understandable, but I'm going to teach you how, because I don't make much. Now, of course, I do pay bills. I don't pay rent right now, because I'm going to school and stuff. It's a situation, but I'll tell you what bills I pay. I pay gas, my car insurance. My gas is a lot too. I drive a big truck. I pay all my utilities. I pay internet. Well, that's a utility. I buy all my groceries, all that. So I have stuff to pay for, right? But I don't make much money. I don't make much money at all. I work 4 days a week as a busboy at a hibachi steakhouse. So I'm going to tell you how I've saved thousands doing that job. Now, I've made some money on some little hustles here and there. I've flipped a few things here and there. And I've also, you know, I've had some ways to make money. I've been out there trying to make money. That's my main goal. But I'm going to tell you guys how I've saved the little money I do make and how you can actually stack money at any level, really. The only thing I see getting away, if you have kids, stuff like that, all this gets a lot harder. But if you're just like a dude like me, just a normal dude, and you're focused, all you want to do is get money, you're young, it's not hard to save money, okay? I'm going to teach you the strategy. Because I'm not good at tracking what I spend. I'm not good at not spending money. Because I love to eat fast food. I'm fucking addicted to this shit. I'm 3 days sober now, but I love to drink, smoke, like take any drug I can really get my hands on, I like anyways. But I'm trying to go sober right now, focus up. So I spend money on drugs. I spend money on all types of bullshit, right? But I'm going to tell you guys how you can save money even if you have bad spending habits. But it's very important that you listen to me, okay? So what's going to happen, you probably have a bank account right now. You probably have a debit card, all right? And what you're doing is you're swiping your little debit card on everything, spending your money. Here's what I want you to do. It's going to take a little effort. It's not hard. So there's online banks, right? You probably go to in-person bank, maybe Wells Fargo, something like that. I personally go to State Employees Credit Union in North Carolina, and I think they give good deals on loans later in life and stuff. I don't need like a house loan yet, but that's why I go there. And so basically that's my main bank, right? In your bank, you'll have a savings and a checking. And your checking's your card, and then the savings like the other account. But they're both accessed, and a lot of times when you go over and you're checking, it comes from your savings. So that's basically just, you could just spend all your money right there on that card. Here's what I want you guys to do. Find a good online bank. I suggest Ally. I use Ally. Now, there's going to be some that are a little better. I just really like Ally. And I like on the app, the actual user interface is really good. But they have a 4.25% interest savings account. Now, that is not enough interest to be an investment. But, so basically, if you don't know, if you're a true beginner to money, that percent, they're going to give you that percent of the money you have in there. They're going to give you 4.25% of the money you have in that bank account every year. But they pay out monthly. They don't pay that amount out monthly, but they break it up. And then over a year, you're getting 4.25% of the money in your account. So what you need to do is set up an online account like that. See, the normal banks, your account's probably going to have like 0.25% interest, something stupid. And you need, I think you have to have 3% to beat interest, I mean to beat inflation. So obviously the value of our money is going down. So you want a savings account that keeps the value of your money a little bit greater than our money going down. So say I have $4,000 in an account and it's at 4.25% interest. Even with inflation, that money will hold its value. Like, it will increase just enough to where it's more than inflation. So I'll have the same amount of money in 20 years. It'll be worth the same amount of money. So it's important to get an online bank account with a decent percentage like that. I suggest Ally, and it's really easy to set up an Ally account. Now, but you don't even have to worry about that. That doesn't even have to be in your mind for this strategy. Sorry, I just ate Taco Bell. Make your Ally account and connect it to your, Wells Fargo, your Truist, whatever, your other account. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna get your paycheck, right? And you're gonna take your paycheck and you're gonna put it in your main account. As soon as you get home and you see that money in your account, you're gonna say, okay, what can I live off of realistically? Like, say, okay, I got a $600 paycheck, right? $600 paycheck, take $100, $200. I mean, if you really have crazy expenses, you're only gonna be take 100 probably, but try to, as much as you can, be so aggressive with it. Like really risk it. Like, risk it. Like, I might not be able, that might not even be enough money for me to live off of, right? It doesn't matter. Take a good chunk of that money. If I had a 600 paycheck, I'm taking 200 out, even if I have stuff coming up. 200 out. Send it to your Ally account, right? Send it to your Ally savings and make a rule with yourself, because I am never gonna transfer the money from the Ally account or the online bank back to my main bank, because when it takes a few days to transfer, so that's like that mitigates the risk of you just swiping away your money. So you move that money over here, and it's not in your main bank account now. And now you're free. This money you have in your bank account, you're free to do whatever the fuck you want with it, because you've already paid your savings $200. And you do that every time you get money from anywhere. You take a decent chunk of it and put it into that account and just forget about it. You're gonna have money in no time. You don't even realize how much money. You don't even have to learn all that. Like, everyone's like, oh, write out a budget, oh, do this, oh, like, all of that takes tons of discipline and hard work to really track what you're doing. Never go out to eat, never get fast food. When you shop, get the cheapest stuff, all that. But if you pay yourself first and never, for no reason, even, okay, say a bill's coming up. Say a bill's coming up, you can't pay with your main money. You better go find a way to get some other money. Don't take it out of that account. That's how I do it. Like, I'm very strict. Like, I never transfer it from that account, right? But it's easy as that. Just pay yourself first. You're basically writing a second paycheck to yourself, right? Because if you pay yourself into that account first, then you have your money that you have access to. So the 600, you put 200 in the savings. You have $400. Do whatever you want. You don't have to budget it. Just make sure you pay your bills. Make sure you pay your bills and make sure you take care of what you need to take care of. But you don't have to budget that money, right? That money is free to use because you've already paid your savings. A lot of people, they have their savings, they're checking in the same bank app, and it's really hard to have that self-control when you're running out on your checking account not to transfer some from your savings. But when it's not even in that account, you're like, oh, I'm just out of money, and it's, I better get some more money somehow. It totally changes the way you think, and it makes it so much more easy to save money. When I started saving money, though, I was saving money in a shoebox with cash, and that was mostly because I wanted to stack up cash and then be like, and I'll put a, the thumbnail will be me holding like, a spread of cash. But now I have a lot more money than that, and it's all in the bank. I'm not going to disclose how much I have, but just know I'm saving the money. And I want you guys to save money too, because it is so common in America, everywhere probably, it's so common not to have any money, like maybe $1,000 saved. That's sad. There's adults, grown-ass fucking adults, that have like $1,000, $2,000 a name. Some of them have like $500. I kid you not. Now, I'll have like $500, $300 just in my normal bank app. I'll be broke in my normal bank app, struggling eating ramen. But I know I have lots of money in my savings. But I act like, basically, I role play being a broke person in my main account because I already paid myself so much. But yeah, I don't have to worry. Like, I can act like a broke person. I can spend my last, as long as I pay my bills, I can spend my last dime on a pre-roll or on a, like, I can spend my last dime on whatever the fuck I want. Okay, I'm not gonna have any money after that, but I can spend my money on whatever the fuck I want because I've already paid myself, and nothing's gonna get me to take that money out and spend it. Nothing. I swear to God, nothing's gonna get me to take that money out and spend it. And that's how you guys need to be. That makes it so much easier to save money, and you'll be like, even if you're not making much money, you'll be like, I didn't realize I could save this much money off my small wages. And if you get big wages, like, and you're just bad at saving, like, bro, if I was making, like, bro, if I was even making, like, $30,000 or $40,000 a year, I already have a lot of money, I think. For how much I make, I think I have a ton of money. But, you know, I'm going to be rich, bro. I swear to God, I'm going to be rich. But I want to help you guys. A lot of you guys aren't going to listen to this, but it's really easy. Just go make that account and hook it up. And then when you get your paycheck, pay yourself first. You can start small, $50, $100 every paycheck. But it's going to save up fast. And I'm going to tell you right now, you wouldn't believe how much having thousands and thousands in the bank is a self-esteem booster. Because you never thought you would be able to get that money. Especially you're always thinking, oh, how to get rich. You're probably looking on YouTube, how to get money, how to get thousands of dollars, blah, 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 blah. But it's not always about how much you make. It's also about how much you stack. And you just need the right strategy. Because I know for sure I have no control over what I'm spending. But it doesn't matter because I've already paid myself. That's what I'm trying to get along to you guys. So yeah. And the more you make, the more you got to pay yourself. All right. Don't fucking, no. If you're making $60,000 a year, don't listen to my video and pay yourself $50 a fucking paycheck. Don't be a bitch. Okay. If you're making good money, save good money. But you know, you guys got this, bro. You can make more money than you think. I believe in you guys. You guys need to listen because you guys are so broke. It's annoying.